As a designer, I design a fair amount of bottles, containers, things like that. So occasionally, I need to scan bottles for one reason or another, to reverse engineer them, figure out certain design features, figure out volume, capture a certain detail. Let's scan a bottle.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and then you hit the bell again, so you get the little parentheses around it. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video.
So to scan a bottle like this, I'm going to use a process called photogrammetry. Photogrammetry is a process where you take a series of photographs of an object and it's able to calculate the form of that object from those photographs and create you some data. So that's what we're going to do with this bottle.
We're going to paint the object that we want to scan, and we want to make it flat, meaning it has no reflections or is not shiny. And we want to create contrast and texture on this form. So we're going to start out by painting this shiny bottle, plastic bottle, with a flat gray primer. That's going to give us the flattest possible, easiest way to make this bottle non-reflective. So we're going to lay on a nice light coat of gray, sort of a medium gray. I'm going to come back and I'm going to dust it with some black primer. And when I say dust it, I want little speckles on this container because I'm trying to create a texture. That texture will become a series of points that the software will use to map the object. I'm going to add a little bit of white here. So again, I'm just dusting very light because I just want little white speckles of paint on the container. Lastly, I'm going to come back again with my black and I'm going to dust it one more time, making the container a little bit darker so I get some good flatness and texture to my container.
So your bottle should look something like this. Very textured, very flat, not shiny. Okay. We're gonna mount it onto this little block. And you do that with some hot glue. Since my block already has some glue on it, just gonna heat up hot glue.
Now that your bottle's mounted, let's set up a place to actually take the series of photographs that we're going to need to generate this mesh. I'm going to set up in my shop space where I have a nice flat table and some halfway decent lighting. To make my lighting even better, I'm going to flatten it by adding a diffuser above the object that I'm scanning. And I'm simply using a piece of paper to eliminate any shadows or reduce them as much as possible. You can see there's some very soft ones at the bottom, but it should be okay for this purpose. You're going to take a series of photographs around this bottle from 360 degrees, from low to high, so that you capture all the possible angles of the object that you're trying to scan. You want to fill the frame as much as you can with every shot. On my camera, it's set to manual. The aperture is set as low as it can go, so it can blur my background and I can get good depth of field. And I also set the ISO and it's locked. The only thing that I use the camera auto for is the focus, so that every single time it focuses on the object that I'm taking a picture of. That way it blurs out the background and I don't have to worry about collecting data other than the object that I'm trying to scan. You're going to do this 360 degrees all the way around the object, making sure to frame the object every single time. This is super important. If you get into a situation where you feel your background is in focus and you don't want it to be in focus, you can place a card behind the object that you're scanning to eliminate that background or, in effect, mask it out. So for this scanning project, we're going to use Metashape from Agisoft. In the past, I've used Recap and stuff from Autodesk, but it's not available on a Mac anymore. It's for an iPad. It's not web-based. It should be, whatever. So I'm using Agisoft Metashape. It works pretty good. You're going to take and you import all of your photos, and then you're going to align the images. And this is pretty cool. It shows you and it figures out where you took the photograph of. If you have a faint little image down there at the bottom, roughly of what your object is, there's a pretty good chance that you're going to succeed at creating a decent mesh. So next, we're going to build the mesh. This can take several minutes, depending upon how much data it has to crunch and how powerful your GPU is or CPU is. And there's our data. It even creates a texture map, which we don't really need. Some graphic artists may need that. We're going to remove the support at the very bottom because we don't really need that. We just want the pure scan from the bottle itself. Let's zoom in here and remove this data. And this is built right in to the application. Many applications have this, and I'm just removing this very carefully at the bottom. And then we're going to fill this hole. This application has the option to fill that hole so we can create a solid object. So when you bring it into some other application, you could, in theory, reprint this bottle if you needed to print it at a different scale, if that was what you needed to do. It's not what I need in this case. I merely need the data to help me rebuild the bottle for this application. So let's save the data. You can export it in many different formats. I'm saving it as an OBJ, DXF. There's many options that you can choose from. I just need the OBJ. So we'll go into the macOS. Has a nice feature. When you hit the space bar after you've selected an object, preview will show you a 3D preview that you can actually rotate around. This is a great way to sort of verify that your data has been exported and looks more or less the way you expect it to look. You can import it into your favorite CAD application. In this case, I'm opening a mesh in Fusion 360. I would think every single CAD application these days pretty much has that capability. There's the bottle. It's going to need a little bit of alignment, maybe some scale adjustment. Those are things that you'll need to do in your CAD package, depending upon what it is you're using the object for, whether it's game creation, just regular design work or graphics. That's going to be up to you, but you should get some decent data using this method that can be very, very useful for whatever kind of project it is that you're doing. So good luck. This just covers the basics of scanning a 3D object. Hope it helps you out. Helps me out tremendously. Look for more content soon. Make sure you follow me on social media, Twitter, Instagram. Links are below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking on the icon in the bottom right of the video or below the video. Give it a thumbs up and follow the channel there as well. Want to know about upcoming design content and projects that I'm working on? Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and my favorite Google+. Links below. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.